Good morning, you guys. It's your boy Stehiko. I know I ain't had one of these vlogs in a good little minute. I'm gonna update y'all on what's been going down. I know y'all probably can't see me right now, so I might just hold off and wait till sun. Basically, the sun is up. But I'm gonna show you a little bit right here. You probably can see this. So the plenum, as y'all can see, basically what I'm already been deleting things. Like, this is the coolant line and water line rails. I'm deleting that. What is it? This too as well. I believe this is part of the I think a water line. Not a water line, but the EGR. I believe that's part of the EGR. And basically, those are like things that you really don't have to have on this car, because what's the point of having all those cooling lines, you know? And at the same time, performance-wise, I ain't gonna say that's gonna do any justice, but it might perform a little bit better. But at the same time, who knows? But I know. Snoopy is like, it's too early for this.
Isaac, shut the hell up! Damn!
Alright, guys, so it's a little bit of daylight. So, what I've been doing, I cleaned this lower intake plenum. And yeah, that's how it looks. All this was gunky, like, literally, all that was gunky. If I had a picture before, I would show y'all, but that's why I should have really did. But yeah, this, I like this setup. I ain't gonna lie, I like this setup. So now what I'm gonna have to do is bypass these two lines. Well, this one is basically, all you're doing is just capping it off, or either you can just run, you know, some regular hoses to each other, and you ain't really got to do all that. Since the motor's still in the car, I'm not going to sit up here and try to cut it, because I'm not going to risk cutting to the harness or anything. So yeah, and I'm probably delete the cruise control while I'm at it, have a lot more space. So it's nothing but two bolts right here, and that's it. So yeah, and that'll be it for my deletes. And then I can go back to, maybe I'm debating about it. I'm debating about changing out those headers. But at the same time, if I do, I'm gonna have to take the valve cover off in order for me to do that. And then in order for me to do that, I got to drain the oil out. So either way it go, I still got plenty more things to do before I can put everything back together and, you know, get it back on the road. But far as this goes, this, I ain't gonna lie, it's been fun. It's fun. See that spot right there on the camera? So my bad if I'm moving the camera around. But anyways, you guys, yeah, I'm gonna get back to it. Okay, guys, I have the first back cover off, which is the easiest side, the passenger side. It actually looks real good, like, no imperfections really on the cams. And the studs and all that looks good. No trash or anything. So, you guys, those of you that be doing, like, you know, valve cover changes on these, make sure if you're gonna leave it like open like this, make sure you cover it up. Look, cover it up real good, so no trash or anything will fall in there, because you can easily mess up your heads. So my spark plug looks real good, really. It looks real good. It's like, y'all can't really see it because this camera can pick it up. But I'm really excited about that because usually I have some type of substance in there, like a yellowy, liquidy substance. And I guess over time it just decided to, disappear or whatever. But yeah, and then this is the EGR right there when I cut. That's part of the EGR. So I cut that basically so you won't have to worry about putting that back into the plenum. And here's the piece right here. Where is it? Right here. That's the piece right there. That's what holds the plenum really down. Besides that, you guys, I'm really debating about doing the headers because the headers on this side, it looks pretty easy, but the other side, the EGR runs into the header. And of course, the bolt, there's always that one rusted bolt that's gonna hold you back from, you know, doing anything. So I'm debating on whether should I just take the test pipe down and go ahead and try it, or just wait and do this another time, like the headers. But at the same time, who knows? It could be just maybe like on the drive. It's on the driver's side. This side, not my bad. The driver's side is where the bolt is. Y'all won't be able to see it because there's so much stuff in the way. And yeah, I cut right here because I did not want to get anywhere near the harness. So I believe I can cut some more if I remove that raggedy, I guess you can say, rigged up little harness holder or whatever. And who knows, maybe I can have more access to cut that way. I ain't gotta have that in the way for the valve cover. Either way it go, I gotta find a way to move this harness some more because it really is gonna get in the way of things. So like I said, you guys, it's a fun process, but this process is a lot faster because we don't have the turbos and all the extra cooler lines and everything down there. So this is like, it's nothing really. Just take your time, make sure you go over thing. You never, you know, you don't want to, like we did last time, let the valve covers leak again. Just let it sit and, you know, sink in. And yeah, so far so good. All right guys, so my package literally just got here. It's like, what, 11 something right now, and it's all everything I need. O-rings for the balance tube, valve cover gasket, not valve cover gasket, but plenum gasket, PCV piping, EGR delete. So you guys know how I was telling y'all about the EGR, probably gonna be hard. Well, I'll tell y'all guys, it's an EGR. The EGR goes into the header on the driver's side. And right now, I've been playing with it, and it came off like loose easily. So there is some hope. It's just, it's time consuming because y'all ain't gonna be able to see it, like I said, because what I've been doing. I mean, it works either way it go. I've cutting this down to 22 mil to like to the point where I can have access to turn, and it's been turning. And like, it wasn't even hard like I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be hard because, you know, we did Jose's, and now, hey, that's it. So really and truly, I may not like get a lot done because I still need my fuel lines and what else. That's about it, I believe. Oh, and auto air control valve, silicone hose, and that'll be it. And everything will be put back together. Which really, I can do the valve cover job today, which I'm probably shoot for. And I'm really trying to aim for to get the EGR out. So, and maybe I guess I'm gonna go ahead and swap the headers. I haven't showed y'all those yet. I'm gonna show y'all those later. So right now I'm just nitpicking at what I really need to focus on right now. So yeah, anywho, I'm getting back to it.
act like I give a fuck. Acting like you different, but you ain't got shit but shit it up. Riding in that shitty truck, 4x4, I lift it up. Dare you to come, bitch, it does. Raise your voice, I listen up. But team says sure ain't listen up. Made a couple ass, I could use a couple more. Show the world a sound they ain't never heard before. I done shed my brain sentence with the ones that don't. Ones that couldn't make it up themselves, copy bones. When it flows, that's a loan. I put interest on them though. What they can't come up with, then respect. I have to take it blood out the mud. I got it, buckets, I shot it. Says she's something that you not. So like tag, you not it. Melody's got him nodding. Ain't no going in pocket. Never scratch, never that. Slaughtered every project. Every place you walk in, just know I'm somewhere watching. The wind that hit the trees, I am the flowers plus the pollen.
Okay, you guys, it's later on in the night. So we got both of the headers off and dropped the test pipes and HVAC and all that. But anywho, we did that. I got one valve cover sealed up already. It's on the exhaust side, the exhaust cam valve cover. Right there on the passenger side, I got that set and we have three more left to do. So my goal for today was to at least get the valve cover sealed up. That way tomorrow we can just put the headers on. Which, y'all want to see how they look? I'm going to show y'all right now. Bam. There they are. So hopefully I get a little bit better performance out of this car and keep the heat down a lot. And then let just let the heat go out through the exhaust system. And whew, trust me you guys, this not everything, but I got some more goodies on the way. Yeah, it's just, I don't know, I've been slacking on this Z, and now basically once we seal all the valve covers up and everything is cleaned up or whatever, I'm pretty sure I gained a little more power too, because I did all the deletes I needed to do. Only thing I didn't delete is the PCB, and I can't delete that because I see the difference with just deleting that and just, you know, having it. When you get a fresh new pair of PCB pipes or anything, your car opens up a lot more. Even if you do want to run a catch can, cool, I get it. But at the same time, I can't do that, because I seen the results with the twin turbo. That's why I said that. And it opened up so much. I was like, wow, that little part right there just had more airflow, you know. So anywho, you guys, I'm gonna end it right here. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. I know it's everywhere. Bear with me, you guys. I'm just trying to, you know, get this thing up and going, because I can't have, you know, I can't have my car down. It's the only car I got. So yeah, if you're new to the channel, thank you for subscribing to the channel. I have a lot more videos coming, so y'all just stick around and just, you know, be patient. I'm in the workings of trying to do more and more like good content. But I see like last content that I did, it shut off. Like it did pretty good, so yeah. But anyways, hopefully y'all enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, comment down below what I should work on, and I'll see y'all in the next part.